speaker is Professor Stefan Alexander Schneider. He is professor of advanced driver systems and the coordinator of a newly founded master course at the University of Applied Sciences in Kempten. After a degree in mathematics and physics and a doctorate in mathematics and computer science, he worked at Infineon Technologies as a development engineer in the Department of Advanced Technology Software. Then at Axiom Software, he designed and developed mathematical optimization methods as a senior system analyst. Afterwards, he worked as method engineer at BMW in modeling multi-domain physical systems, particularly using Modelica. So, Professor.
So, buongiorno tutti, and that's all my Italian I know for today. I switch to the international airport language. Okay, I want to take you in the next 25 minutes to the journey from advanced driver assistance systems to autonomous driving, and what is the key factor in that. Okay, thank you very much for the introduction, for kind introduction, and for the invitation, and to be here with you today and to present these topics. Okay. Here in this picture you can see the important stuff. This is the environment and the car and the driver, or even not the driver, so how to replace the driver. As already mentioned, mobility is in the move. In former days it was to the possession of a car to get freedom, and now it switches to mobility as a service. And I may ask you, what is your experience with traffic jams? How long did you stuck at the longest time in a traffic jam? So may you raise your hand, 1 hour, 5 hours, okay, there are some already, sorry, have to go, 10 hours, 1 day. So what do you think is the longest traffic jam? 1 day, 2 days, 5 days. So I show you the longest traffic jam to be recorded.
A 9-day traffic jam in China is now more than 100 kilometers long and could last for weeks, state media reported Monday. Thousands of trucks en route to Beijing from Huain in the southeast have been backed up since August 14, making the National Expressway 100 impassable, Xinhua News reported. A spokesman for the Beijing Traffic Management Bureau reportedly told China's Global Times newspaper that the backup was due to insufficient traffic capacity caused by maintenance construction. The construction is scheduled to last until September 13.
Okay, so even when I come yesterday from the Brenner down, also small traffic congestion, but 10 days in traffic congestion, you can imagine. And this happens in China. It was not an accident. It was a not well-planned order of construction sites. And you can believe that economy that it's based on that the people can come to work, and where the people need all their years' holidays to get to work because they are stuck in a traffic jam 10 days, this economy breaks down, and this is why we see, especially in China, so lots of efforts to overcome these problems, mobility problems, and one part is their autonomous driving. Okay, and the paradigm is changing from possessing a car to have the service of mobility, and the mean, you know this, there's a lot of apps available. This is the mean how to access to that. So you have bikes, planes, cars, trains, and all this stuff. And the question is now how to combine these different suggestions for means of traffic to resolve my personal need. And therefore, it's no wonder that the automotive industry, as the two presentations we have seen already before is longing to or heading to autonomous driving. And there are two paradigms that we see. One paradigm is increase small steps with new functions that you can see here. You have autonomous emergency brake, you have a wake assistant, traffic sign detection, rear end collision avoidance systems, autonomous braking system, park support, light control, lane keep assist, park systems, and so on, and incrementally go towards the autonomous driving. And the other concept or paradigm that we see is especially by some companies in the far west of the United States, like Google, Apple, or Tesla, that they say, okay, we go directly to autonomous driving, which, by the way, releases us a lot of testing efforts because we don't have to think about to take over or to throw away the control of the car with a driver. Okay, so
the BMW Group is implementing fully autonomous driving over five levels of development. In the process, the responsibility for driving the car will shift from the person at the wheel to the car itself. Today, the second level has already been reached. Here, the driver is aided by assistance systems and can remove their hands from the steering wheel for brief periods. At the third level, they will sometimes be able to completely turn their attention away from driving, but must be able to step in again at short notice. Once level 4 is reached, the driver might even be able to sleep. They must, however, still be basically fit to drive in case they have to take over control of the car for specific sections of the journey. It is at the final level of development that cars will drive fully autonomously. The driver will become another passenger and won't even have to be able to drive, as the car will assume complete responsibility for the task of driving. At level 2, stereo cameras and radar sensors monitor the immediate surrounding area. Level 3 requires highly advanced sensors, such as laser scanners, ultrasonic sensors, and radar systems, which together produce a 360-degree model of the vehicle's environment. This makes it possible to calculate more complex driving maneuvers. For level 4, fully automated driving from 2021, all sensors and cameras will supply far more precise data, while the real-time data from the area maps provided by HERE will also be factored into the process of computing driving maneuvers. And level 5, the first pilot projects for fully autonomous driving are due to get underway in selected cities from as early as 2020. For the BMW Group, the vision of fully autonomous driving has long since begun.
So, okay, this is a promotion video from BMW, but I'm sure you see, we have seen already from Ford and all the other companies, especially the companies in Japan, they are heading to the autonomous driving. Here, the goal is to present in Japan at the Olympic Games in 2020. That the Olympionics are driven by autonomous cars from the stadiums back to the dormitories and back. Okay, so we have to replace the driver and all the abilities of the driver, which makes it fairly hard. And this is why at the moment all is talking about ADAS, because we have to replace the sense of the human, the human as a sensor, by different sensors, is the radar, the LiDAR, the camera, ultrasonic sensors, and maps, and so on. Okay, here again, the five levels. I won't go in details because we're lacking in time, and I think they have already shown in the last two presentations. Step by step, we replace the abilities of the driver, and this is why we also have to understand what the driver's function in a car is, and what his abilities are. Okay, so this is, we talk of driver in responsibility and then the car in responsibility. Here just a short slide about the situation where we are at the moment. So this is in market, active cruise control and lane keep assistance, which is so annotated to the level 1. Then it's independent, so if you take them together, then you are almost in level 2. And this is where are we at the moment, in research. And these are the topics of the research. towards the level 5, and here you see sensor and the modeling of the sensor behavior models for camera, for radar, for LiDAR. We, especially my group at the university, we are working on that. We have now presented a camera behavior model based on the function mockup interface and the open simulations interface coming up now, and this is available now. Okay, so, and these are the ideas that the autonomous industry or others and AD penetrates the market. I think it's clear that automated driving is in place. It's about 40 years old technologies. And the question, when is autonomous driving in place, is to be replaced by the penetration. When we have 25, 50%, 75% of penetration by the autonomous driving. And these are some scenarios to increase this penetration. There's one, first of all, here on the right side, you see the driving velocity, of course, and on the high y-axis, you see the driving complexity in, say, something like rules to be taken into consideration for the driving. And this is typically the place for motorways here, because you have relatively high speed, but small environmental complexity, because all the cars are going one direction, it's a fenced area and so on. And but you have the big impact in an accident. And so this is one path going to level 5. For example, in Germany, we have the digital test area A9, motorway A9, between Munich and Nuremberg. And the other idea now to reduce the impact of the accidents is to go in cities, in smart cities. But unfortunately, you have high complexity, driving complexity there. Are you faced to that? And so this is the other way going towards autonomous driving. And what is at the moment not thought about is the rural area, where you have both disadvantages, relatively high speed and relatively high complexity. So the two passes actually to be seen is motorways going level 5 or smart cities with valued parking. Okay, and here we see it again. There are a lot of proving grounds on the world. I just pick out one, which is 2.5 hours from here in Ljubljana, newly founded automated vehicle living lab in a former staple place of the Yugoslavia, where they changed the whole city into a proving ground or experience area for the humans in work, humans in life, in sports, and so on. And if they go shopping. And then we have the next is this digital test field motorway A9 I already talked about. And we are going to have a proving ground in the Allgäu, which is a rural area. And I will present you the first results about a step towards this. And this is a project, Zukunft der Mobilität in the Bergtälern, which is the future of the mobility in protected natural preservation valleys.
Das okay. Oberallgäu ist mit seinem privilegierten Zugang zu den angrenzenden Alpen ein beliebtes Reise- und Ausflugsziel. Touristen, Einheimische und Besucher aus der Region suchen nach naturnaher Freizeitgestaltung und Erholung. Sie genießen die Ruhe der Berge, wandern oder betätigen sich sportlich in sauberer Luft. Diese Attraktivität hat allerdings ihren Preis. Die Region ist schon heute zeitweilig von einer Überlastung im Freizeitverkehr betroffen. Der öffentliche Personennahverkehr ist lückenhaft und erfolgt überwiegend durch umweltschädliche Dieselbusse und Bahnen. Die kleinen Ortschaften leiden an Verkehrsüberlastung durch Parkplatzsuchende oder Durchreisende. Probleme, die sich tendenziell eher noch verschärfen werden. Die Zukunft der Mobilität in geschützten Bergtälern steht im Fokus des Modellprojekts ZUMOBE. Es soll untersucht werden, ob zukünftig autonome, elektrisch betriebene Fahrzeuge einen Beitrag zur Lösung der bestehenden Probleme leisten können. Das Landratsamt Oberallgäu hat in Kooperation mit der Hochschule Kempten und der Universität Innsbruck die Gemeinden Oberstdorf und Bad Hindelang gewinnen können, zwei Strecken zu finden, in denen ein autonomer, elektrisch betriebener Kleinbus als Forschungsfahrzeug erprobt werden kann. Ein Vorhaben, das in absehbarer Zeit das Thema Mobilität im ländlichen Raum grundlegend verändern könnte. Jede Verbesserung des öffentlichen Personennahverkehrs im ländlichen Raum ist Beitrag zum Klimaschutz, so der Klimaschutzbeauftragte des Oberallgäus, Simon Steuer. Seine Zukunftsvision ist ein klimaneutraler, wirtschaftlicher, bedarfsorientierter öffentlicher Nahverkehr. Autonome, elektrische Shuttlebusse sollen den bestehenden öffentlichen Nahverkehr nicht ersetzen, sondern sinnvoll und bedarfsgerecht ergänzen. Diese Fahrzeuge könnten in Ortsteile oder zu Uhrzeiten verkehren, die bisher aus Kostengründen schlecht oder gar nicht vom öffentlichen Nahverkehr bedient werden. Denkbar wäre zum Beispiel eine flexible, taxiähnliche Nutzung auf Abruf. Auch der Transport von Waren oder Gepäckstücken wären mögliche Anwendungen für ein derartiges Shuttle. Die beteiligten Hochschulen sehen die ausgewählten Strecken als ideale, technisch sehr anspruchsvolle Testumgebung an. Die teilweise für den Individualverkehr gesperrten Strecken stellen eine hervorragende Versuchsumgebung dar. Der von den Akteuren in der autonomen Fahrforschung bislang vernachlässigte Bereich der ländlichen Vorgebirgsregionen birgt viele umweltbedingte Herausforderungen. Jedoch gerade das macht es für die beteiligten Wissenschaftler und Experten so interessant, neue Erkenntnisse und Einsichten zu gewinnen. In einer mit EU-Geldern geförderten ersten Projektphase wurden die ausgewählten Strecken und deren Umweltparameter aufwendig erfasst und virtuell nachgebildet. In einer späteren Phase soll dann unter Verwertung der Erkenntnisse aus der hochkomplexen Simulation ein für diese Umgebung optimierter, realer, autonomer, elektrischer Shuttlebus als Prototyp betrieben werden. Für die Region wäre das ein technologisches und ökologisches Leuchtturmprojekt. Wenn hier eines Tages umweltfreundliche, autonome Busse verkehren würden, wäre das ein Highlight für das Oberallgäu als Tourismusregion, so der Landrat des Oberallgäus, Anton Klotz. Die Werbewirksamkeit und das öffentliche Interesse eines so zukunftsorientierten Themas ist nicht zu unterschätzen. In Bad Birnbach, wo bereits ein autonomer Kleinbus im Einsatz ist und große mediale Resonanz findet, stieg die Anzahl der Übernachtungen seit der Thermengründung vor 40 Jahren auf ein Allzeithoch. Das Oberallgäu könnte mit dem Projekt eine Vorreiterrolle als Innovationsstandort in Sachen Klimaschutz, Technologie und Ökologie erlangen.
So, and this is now the end of the first phase, because we did it like in the automotive development. We started with requirements capturing, with interviews of the people, of the operators and so on. We then modeled this, the driver, the vehicle, the environment, and we then simulated, and it turns out that it looks quite promising. And therefore, we enhanced the six levels, actually six levels, because zero level is no assistance, with another four levels because of swarms of vehicles that they will operate in a staged way together. Okay, so virtualization of the proving ground is now most critical. You can imagine this proving ground like the motorway or the smart cities or in Ljubljana or our proving ground in Allgäu. We need to have a digital twin, and this brings me to the headlight of this conference. We need a digital twin, and we need tools to model all these topics. And then in a virtualization of this proving ground, which we see here, we define the top level requirements, we systematically build up space of potential solutions, model them, simulate them, and then validate them and find the best way how these cars or these vehicle ego these electrical vehicles, autonomous electrical vehicles, can move then. Why or what is all to virtualize? A small basic lecture in advanced driver assistance systems. So we have to see that the vehicle, the driver, the vehicle and the environment and the interfaces with that. So what does advanced driver assistance systems really do? So it needs an abstraction of the driver. So what is the state of the driver? What does the driver want? You need an abstraction of the vehicle, and this is fairly the best abstraction available because you have 10,000 of signals in the car that you can access to, and you need an abstraction of the environment, and this is actually the hardest point at the moment. And for this abstraction, you need also the sensor behavior models, so how you can sense them. And this is feed in the others component, typically on one or several ECUs. Now new players are entering, like NVIDIA, and shows the diffusion of the environment is possible. And then this others functionality steers on the vehicle, and with that the control loop is closed. And here you see the need of the modeling. Here first we saw a drive to drive, then this was virtualized, this replay to sim called, and once you have this in captured in the computer, then you can change in rain, fog, snow and so on, and see how the car, the ego vehicle, then performs in this exactly same situation as it was recorded, and you see the impact of all the improvements. Okay, so time's going by. I just opened a little bit the curtain to see what's coming up there. Actually, there is a gold rush area at the moment, autonomous driving, towards autonomous driving, and there's a lot to do. And why should mankind invest 100,000 of development hours every year to develop a new technology? We saw one motivation just one talk before, so to feed the world and to do also other stuffs in the world. For example, in the mines of Western Australia, it's so dry and so hard to work and so hot that people are get flown in from there, and as a working student you can get as much money as an engineer at BMW. You are flown 1,000 miles from the west coast there, you work 3 months and then you are flown out again. Okay, and maybe one day we have it like that. So, if you think empathically with the pedestrians or the bicycle drivers, maybe this is not what you expect, but we thought all of this also with the elevator. 50 years ago in the elevator, there was a person who just presses the button to bring me up. To bring me up the elevator, now this person is left. Maybe the bottleneck of our mobility, the junctions, will be served like this. We never know. We will see that. And the future is open. We can contribute to that. And I think this is also one aim of the conference, to show potentials for contribution to that. I just want to invite you to contribute to that, because it's a really interesting topic. Not only from the technology side of the car, but also from the how our brain is working and what we do and what we perceive and how we act and how we steer the cars and so on. And you need to know that, by the way, the human-machine interface is a critical point in all this topic, and also the sound development is important for the people. So to accept these new technologies. And yeah, and me personally, I contributed to that because Or by the way, that I'm heading a master course of advanced driver assistance systems in Kempten in the Allgäu, which was founded by a political, by industrial initiative. And here you can see some contributions on the platform 2580.com from powered by Continental. And yeah, we have also introduced others YouTube channel. You find that, and you find all these videos I showed you, and lots of other interesting topics around the autonomous and others driving. Okay, so far, then thank you, tante grazie, and I give back to the organization.
Thank you, Professor Schneider, for his interesting insight into an area where it's not just technology, there's plenty of technology, but something else as well.